Hey guys, so welcome to Tech Ed Today. I know we are doing the top 19 phones of 2019. We did category 1 that had the top phones under 30,000. These were 6 phones. You can take a look at that video. I will link it in the description below. And you can get to see some of the phones. And I know some of you are thinking some of the phones of 2019 that were amazing that you didn't see the video. I'm going to add in the description box some of the phones of 2019 under 30K that are good for you to purchase. Some of you asked this in the comments and in our interactions on Facebook. So I'm going to add that. So today we're going to be talking about the top phones under 50,000. This is the range between 30,000 and 50,000. These are all the phones that came out in 2019. And I'm going to pick the top 6. And these are the phones that we're going to be talking about. We're going to have the Nokia 7.2. We're going to have the Samsung Galaxy A70. The Vivo V17 Pro. The Oppo Reno 2F. And in that category, we're also going to add the S10e. And the Samsung Galaxy A80. So stay tuned and we'll get you teched. So before I continue, a big shout out to Mobile Hub Kenya. They're having amazing discounts this Christmas, so you can go and get phones that are very amazing discounts and very amazing rates. You can even consider to buy somebody as a Christmas present this time around. So link also their page in the description section and you can check out Mobile Hub Kenya. So to begin us up, is the Nokia 7.2. I'd say the least favorite in this list, but the Nokia 7.2 is also an amazing phone you can buy under 50,000. It's a Nokia trying to rebrand themselves and come out as a pop-up brand, but this is a Nokia 7.2. It's a 6.3 full HD plus LCD display. It's quite interesting that it's not an AMOLED, it's an LCD display, but that's what you get. So this is the Nokia 7.2. It comes with an octa-core Qualcomm Snapdragon 660 processor. It's 6 GB of RAM, 128 GB of storage. It packs a triple camera array setup, a 48-megapixel main sensor, an 8-megapixel ultra-wide, and a 5-megapixel depth sensor. It also packs a 20-megapixel Z's selfie camera. And to pack that all up, interestingly, for all that money, it's a 3500 milliampere battery with 10 watts charging. So that's the Nokia 7.2. It's amazing. Nokia trying to rebrand. The design is amazing of the phone. I like it. So next in line is the Samsung Galaxy A70. This is the Samsung Galaxy A70. It looks quite amazing. It's a 6.7 inch Full HD Super AMOLED display. At least we are beginning to talk about AMOLED and Super AMOLED. So this is Super AMOLED by Samsung. It's an octa-core processor. It's a Qualcomm Snapdragon 675. So a better processor to the Nokia. But the 675 is what this one packs. It's a 6 GB of RAM. It's 128 GB of storage. It comes with a triple camera array also. It's a 32 megapixel main sensor, 8 megapixel ultra wide, and 5 megapixel depth sensing. It also comes with a 32 megapixel selfie shooter, so it's interesting to take all your amazing selfies. It's a massive 4500 milliampere battery. So at least this is gonna last you all day long on battery, and it packs a 15 watt super fast charger, and that's what you get with the Samsung Galaxy A70. A very interesting buy, I can tell you. It's on the low range of this budget. It goes for around 35,000, but that's the Samsung Galaxy A70. If you like straight up tech content like this, you can like our page on Facebook. I'm gonna link that in the description also. And you can also hit the massive subscribe button. I'll appreciate that. And you're gonna get more content like this. So next is the Vivo V17 Pro. This phone amazes me. I'd like to test it out for myself, but I know this is a device that you'd like to buy for yourself this 2019. This is the Vivo V17 Pro. It's a 6.44 inch Super AMOLED display. It's a full HD plus display resolution type. It's amazing. It's a Qualcomm Snapdragon 675, just like the Samsung Galaxy A70. And let's just look at the internals. I like it because it's an 8 gigabyte RAM. It's 128 gigabytes of storage. It packs a quad camera. It's 4 cameras, so I'm telling you, it's gonna take interesting photos. The quad camera on this is a 48 megapixel main sensor, an 8 megapixel ultra wide, a 13 megapixel telephoto. You can zoom in on this stuff. So that's a 13 megapixel telephoto and a 2 megapixel depth sensing. Now the wow factor about the Vivo V17 Pro, it's its dual pop-up selfie camera. It comes with 2 cameras in the dual pop-up. It's a 32 megapixel and an 8 megapixel. That's the 2 cameras on selfie department. So you can take more and more people in your shot. That's very, very interesting about the Vivo V17 Pro. And the fact that it has a dual pop-up tells you that it's a complete immersive display without any interruptions, no notch, no punch-outs, nothing. It's a pop-up camera. That's interesting about the Vivo V17. It's also a 4,100 milliampere battery to power you through the day, and it's powered up by 18 watts, so it's gonna get juiced pretty fast. And that's the Vivo V17 Pro. This is a device I'd recommend for many. It's in that bracket. It's amazing. So check out the Vivo V17 Pro and tell me what you think about it. This is the Oppo Reno 2F. Oppo. This is the Oppo Reno 2F. I wish they got us the Oppo Reno Ace or the Gundam version, because they released interesting versions of the Oppo Reno. But the pop-up on this is also interesting. So the same phone made by the same company, we're hoping for the same performance. So this is the Oppo Reno 2F. It's a 6.5 AMOLED Full HD Plus display. It's a MediaTek Helio P70 octa-core chip inside here, so it's gonna handle your mid-range task very well. It's a 8 gigabyte RAM, 128 gigabytes of storage. It comes with a quad camera setup. When we move over to this side, it's a quad camera setup, and in that quad camera setup is a 48 megapixel main camera, 8 megapixel ultra wide, a 2 megapixel black and white. Imagine me in black and white. It's a 2 megapixel black and white and 2 megapixel depth sensor. So that's what you get on the main cameras at the back. You get a 16 megapixel pop-up selfie camera. So it also tells you it's an immersive display with no interruptions, because the pop-up comes on top. And the interesting things about these two devices, or the devices with the pop-up camera, is they have fall detection. So when your phone is about to fall, it detects that it's falling and it brings it back the camera that pops out. So that's interesting for you to know. It's also a 4000 milliampere battery with 20 watts of fast charge. It's what Oppo calls VOOC Flash Charge 3.0. I feel like saying that again. VOOC Flash Charge 3.0. That's what you get with the Oppo Reno 2F. This is also a very interestingly hands-on device. And by the way, if you know, Oppo is having a competition. So you can check out Oppo's page. And these are some of the devices that you can get under 50,000. To add onto this list, to make our top 6, is the Samsung Galaxy A80. If you're talking about pop-ups and motorized cameras, the Samsung Galaxy A80 is a phone that will wow you. It's a 6.7-inch Super AMOLED display. It's a Full HD Plus display. No interruptions at all. It's super immersive. I like that about it. It also packs an octa-core processor with the Snapdragon 730 processor. That's interesting. It will power up your activities of the day. At the back, the cameras at the back are the cameras at the front. The cameras at the front are the cameras at the back. So these are the cameras that the phone has. So these are the 3 cameras on the Samsung Galaxy A80. The primary 48 megapixel, the 8 megapixel ultra wide, and the time of flight 3D camera sensor. That's interesting, because it packs a 3700 milliampere battery, but with actually 25 watt of power, so that's interesting. But this is a device that looks interestingly beautiful and performs interestingly beautiful also. So that's the Samsung Galaxy A80, and that's the 5th phone in this category. And let's talk about the 6th phone. This is the Samsung Galaxy S10e. It's a 5.8-inch dynamic AMOLED display, dynamic. It's not just the super, this one's dynamic. Interesting. It's powered by the Exynos 9820, the same chipset on the S10 and the S10 Plus. So it's interesting, for a cheaper phone, you get the same kind of processor, and processor is about everything on a phone. So that's the Samsung Galaxy S10e for you. It packs a 12 megapixel primary camera. You look at 12 megapixels, you think, how would it match against the 48 megapixels and the 32 megapixels? But interestingly, the 12 megapixel on the Samsung S10e would outperform some of these devices. So it's the 12 megapixel main camera and 16 megapixel ultra wide. It's also 6 GB of RAM and 128 GB of storage. It also comes with a 10 megapixel selfie camera. You to take your trusting selfies of this. It's a punch out. That's the difference. We have notches, we have pop-ups, and we have punch outs. So the S10e is a punch out, takes interesting photos. It's a 3100 milliampere battery. I wonder how that would do in a full day of massive usage like I do on my phone. But it's a 3100 milliampere battery, and it's powered by a 25 watt charger. So these are the top 6 phones of 2019 under 50,000. That's the Nokia 7.2, the Samsung Galaxy A70, the Vivo V17 Pro, the Oppo Reno 2F, which I'm falling in love with, the Samsung Galaxy A80, and the Samsung Galaxy S10. You guys tell me, what do you think about my top 6 under 50,000? Interact with me and tell me whether you think there are phones here you think are overrated, or there are phones you think I should have included in this list. Now, and one more thing, share with us your love by liking the video, subscribing, and sharing with your friends. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out.